And here is the Writer's Almanac for Sunday. It's the 28th of July, 2019. It's the birthday of the poet John Ashbery, born Rochester, New York, 1927, grew up on his family's fruit farm near Lake Ontario, went to a small rural school. He was a bright young man and a generous neighbor, seeing that, paid to send him to a good school for his last 2 years of high school, and he started writing poetry. Went on to Harvard, published his first book when he was 29, a book entitled Some Trees. John Ashbery, who said, "I don't quite understand about understanding poetry. I experience poems with pleasure, whether I understand them or not. I'm not quite sure. I don't want to read something I already know or which is going to slide down easily. There has to be some crunch, a certain amount of resilience." John Ashbery, who wrote in his poem At North Farm, "Somewhere, someone is traveling furiously toward you, at incredible speed, traveling day and night, through blizzards and desert heat, across torrents, through narrow passes. But will he know where to find you, recognize you when he sees you, give you the thing he has for you?" It's the birthday of the poet Gerard Manley Hopkins, born in Stratford near London, 1844, went to a fancy boarding school, wrote poems, he was a painter, went on to Oxford to study the classics, and while he was there, he had a religious conversion. His parents were Anglicans, but the young Hopkins decided to become a Catholic, inspired by John Henry Newman, whose book Apologia Pro Vita Sua was a bestseller while Hopkins was at Oxford. 2 years later, Hopkins decided to become a Jesuit priest, and he began his training. He burned all of his poems, said he was giving up poetry. Didn't write at all for 7 years, until 1875, when a German passenger ship, the SS Deutschland, sank in a storm. 75 passengers died, including 5 Franciscan nuns who were escaping harsh anti-Catholic laws. And he wrote a long poem, The Wreck of the Deutschland. And now that he saw poetry as a way to express his faith, he started writing again. In the year he was ordained as a priest, 1877, he wrote some of his best-known poems, including The Windhover, As Kingfishers Catch Fire, Dragonflies Draw Flame. And he wrote God's Grandeur, the famous poem that begins, "The world is charged with the grandeur of God." He went through desperate hard times as a priest, was sent to Dublin, which he hated. He became very depressed, doubted his own religious faith, even contemplated suicide. Died of typhoid fever at the age of 44. During his lifetime, he had published only a handful of poems. Here's a poem for today by Jane Kenyon, "Let Evening Come." Let the light of late afternoon shine through chinks in the barn, moving up the bales as the sun moves down. Let the cricket take up chafing as a woman takes up her needles and her yarn. Let evening come. Let dew collect on the hoe abandoned in long grass. Let the stars appear and the moon disclose her silver horn. Let the fox go back to its sandy den. Let the wind die down. Let the shed go black inside. Let evening come. To the bottle in the ditch, to the scoop in the oats, to air in the lung, let evening come. Let it come as it will, and don't be afraid. God does not leave us comfortless, so let evening come. A poem by Jane Kenyon from her collected poems, Let Evening Come, published by Grey Wolf Press and used by permission here on the Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.